Welcome, folks. I am Jabby Kuwait, joined by Achara Kirk.
Hey there.
The Batman DC fandom teaser has just dropped a few moments ago. We're going to watch it. But before I get into that, I wanted to address some of the rumors that had been going around about Robert Pattinson that were, like, we were unclear as to whether they were jokes or not. And I spoke to someone who actually worked on the Batman closely with Robert Pattinson.
Yes.
And he was saying that Robert Pattinson actually worked his ass off on this movie. Like, he was working out all the time, and all that nonsense about him not wanting to work out for this role was all a bunch of baloney. And he actually is very, very, like,
committed,
and he works his butt off because he wants to get this done right. And so the thing about the underwear, he couldn't really speak to. He never heard about that. Apparently, I'm like, how do you not know about that? You worked on the movie. So he didn't know about that. So I can't address that particular thing. Here we go.
You're becoming quite a celebrity. Why is he writing to you?
If you are justice, please do not lie. What is the price for your...
I'm vengeance.
That looks super cool, actually. I'm into it. I'm into it, and I'm also super excited that there's Catwoman, because she's my fave.
I'm letting it all kind of settle in. I'm letting it all settle in, because this is the most we've seen of this. This is like,
yeah.
I'm happy. I'm also cautiously optimistic at the same time. I think that this could be really good, but I don't want to get my hopes up.
Yeah.
And I heard him speak for the first time as Batman, and I actually thought that was very, very interesting because it's way different from Christian Bale's Batman voice.
Mm-hmm.
It still has the sort of like quiet,
the gravelly.
It's well, that's what he's aiming for.
Yeah.
But it almost has a softness to it, but I'm not necessarily mad at it.
I liked it actually.
It was interesting to say the least. Because I was a lot more easy to understand than Christian Bale's.
Oh yeah, yeah.
You know, like it's hard to make out what he was. It was hard to make out what he was saying in that movie. Not that he did a bad job, but like I had a hard time understanding half of what he said in that film.
Mm-hmm.
And so here it's like, okay, well I know that I'll be able to understand what Robert Pattinson is saying. You definitely get the vibe of the city. And that's something I mentioned earlier in a previous reaction that we did, which is, you know, one of the things that I felt the Batman Begins at least fell short on was really defining that city, because Gotham City is supposed to be a very corrupt place that necessitates having a Batman. And here, it feels like you're seeing that more, and it feels like you're getting a stronger sense about it. Just before this, there was some from the DC fandom website, you heard the director talking at length, and just his enthusiasm behind it and everything he was trying to do with it. And
yeah,
you really get that sense of someone who really cares about this story. This isn't just like, you know, something coming out of a corporate machine. Like, it feels like someone who really cares about this and wants to do this right, who wants to really tell a good Batman story. And I can appreciate that. And it feels like, in a way, it's nodding to the Nolan series. It has a similar look, a similar vibe, but still somehow finds its own look and vibe. I don't know if that's making any sense. It's like, it's not too far different. It's not too much of a departure, but it's also not unique, if that makes any sense.
Well, yeah, because it's still got to make sense as part of the Batman universe, right? And
right.
So it has that similar sort of darkness and grittiness that we've become familiar with the Nolan stuff. But then here, I feel like, at least in the teaser, there's that addition of the red, which seems to be this common trope going through the various first looks and things that we've seen from this film.
Right.
But it's cool. And I was really digging the Batmobile. I thought the Batmobile looked super sexy, kind of almost like the Knight Rider car.
Sure.
And yeah, I thought it looked really cool.
The thing that's still growing on me, and this is just me being totally honest, the thing that's still growing on me is the bat suit, because it has more of a pseudo practical look to it,
right,
as opposed to being a costume. I think that the Dark Knight costume was really, really good. It was stellar. Let's get it right, you know. The Batman costume from the Tim Burton series will always have a special place in my heart, from specifically Michael Keaton.
Yes.
And so this one, it's like, it's cool. I'm not mad at it, but I don't know if I'm a huge fan of it just yet. I'm getting into it, you know?
In the panel, didn't the director say that he wanted it to look more like something that was a little bit more homemade? Rather than like, it seems like in the other movies, his suit was so much more, you know, high tech, which also makes sense because Bruce Wayne is a billionaire?
Yes.
Or at least he's got several millions in the bank, right? So he can—
He's a billionaire.
Yeah, he can afford to do that,
yeah.
Right? But I guess in this one, they're kind of going all the way back to the beginning and kind of showing where he's starting from. Because even earlier on, he was almost daredeviling it with like a covering on his face.
If you watch Mask of the Phantasm, I believe that's what it's called, he used to have a daredevil thing, but like over his, you know, his mouth was exposed, but he had a hood on.
Right.
That it's similar to the Batman costume,
right,
but it's just a hood, not necessarily covering his mouth. But in any case, like, you still get that same sort of vibe. It feels like a young Batman, and
yeah,
I feel like this could be really, really good, and that's got me excited. Because I don't know that we've ever really truly seen a young Batman, other than Batman Beyond, but that's not Bruce Wayne.
Right.
So it's usually like you see him as a kid, then you see him as a much older guy,
mm-hmm,
you know, the Playboy millionaire, by day. Playboy billionaire, excuse me, by day, and then, you know, Batman by night. And so this is really cool. I'm probably gonna study the shit out of this trailer as soon as we're done doing this, discussion, but it's interesting how you're really getting a sense as to, here you've got this vigilante superhero, but he's having to wrestle with the fact that because of him, people's lives are being endangered as well, because he's being targeted by the nemesis in the film, you know, the antagonist in the film. And that's always an interesting play that they did explore in The Dark Knight. And I think it's cool that they're exploring it again here.
And I liked the look of the action as well, when he got to like, I don't know, I mean, I think that you probably can look at it more critically than me, but I liked the feel of it being so visceral, and like the sound design on it. It just felt like really raw.
It wasn't,
you know?
In my opinion, it wasn't the best camera angle for it, but what I did appreciate about it was it wasn't cutting it up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was showing you right away, this is not Christopher Nolan. Because what Christopher Nolan would do is it was like often shaky stuff, or it was like cutting a lot. It was hard to follow the fight scene. And people complained about it so much that when he got to The Dark Knight Rises, when there was the epic fight between Batman and Bane, he just let the camera, he didn't even cut, right? And so they followed a similar note here, it seemed like, where the camera didn't even cut. It was just him doing his thing. I just wish it was a different angle, because it felt like a lot of it was being lost in the back of the dude.
Mm-hmm.
But you still got the sense of it because you saw Batman's movement, you heard the sound effects, you still got the vibe of it overall, and it told you that when you see fighting happening in this movie, the action will be clearer. And I very much appreciate that as someone who has choreographed lots of fight scenes, who shot and been in lots of fight scenes, I appreciate that a lot. So bravo to that. You guys, thanks so much for hanging out with us. Hopefully you enjoyed that. Let us know your feelings in the comments below. Check out Achara Kirk on the social media, as well as the Jabs, if you feel like doing that. Instagram, Twitter, all that good stuff. Check out our other reactions, reviews, short films, vlogs, and interviews. I'm Jabby Koi. This is
Achara Kirk.
Peace out.